We're going to go from Ennis to here in Thurles and Tipperary's attempts to do something that they haven't done in each of their last four championship games against Limerick, and that's win.
Everything is set for this Munster Hurling Championship between Limerick and Tipperary.
The atmosphere was just unbelievable.
There is such a rivalry between Limerick and Tipperary. Seamus Flanagan. Limerick beat Tipperary and reached the Munster final.
Oh, it rebounds back in the net. And oh my word, a fantastic goal. Goal of the year.
And it's another one for you know who, Alan Gard.
Nightmare stuff really for the Tipperary fans.
Oh, I suppose this is the real tester today.
We have another huge game on the penultimate weekend of the Munster Hurling Championship, Tip versus Limerick, starting at 4 o'clock. And Donal Logue, Limerick obviously have these 3 weeks since the Clare defeat. Have they been plotting ever since something different to bring to the table today?
I think that came at the right time, right? So they've been on the road for a long go. They could reset, reframe the situation, take stock, let their backroom team earn their money, right, in terms of getting the mindset right. And I'm expecting today a huge response out of Limerick, and I think that 3 weeks break will have suited them.
Interestingly, Cathal O'Neill is actually a late change to the team. He's coming in for Peter Casey in the forward line. Do you expect from the, Joe, from the Tipperary team that was named and that is going to start, are you expecting a more defensive setup from them?
I think so. I think they're a little bit conscious of conceding, what was it, 7 goals in the last couple of games. And I think even with Dan McCormick going to midfield, Ronan Maher going back into cornerback, I think they're going to be more compact. Just reading from the way they're lining out, is that the right thing to do against Limerick? We've seen Clare push up in Limerick and get a result. I think it's the wrong thing to do and sit back against Limerick, because it allows your Barry Nashes and these guys, Declan Hannan, to get on the ball and move it out. I think if Tip want to be successful, they have to push up. But then again, I think they're a little bit afraid of conceding goals. So it's kind of, what do you do?
Yeah. Like, I think, yeah, the 7 goals has to be a worry for him.
Yeah,
but at
yeah.
the same time, he has the stopgap of a team that are out of Munster next week. Okay, there could be a kick in them, but they'll be expected to win. I know it's Waterford's home game, but it's still here in Thurles. There's a few things with the Tip full back line. Does Michael Breen go out after Cathal O'Neill now? Because we expect that he'll play the Peter Casey role of coming deep with Flanagan and Gillan side. Or do they want Kyle Barrett to go out, as he did with Tony Kelly? Or do they want Kyle Barrett and Aaron Gillan, who've had some tussles down through the years?
Yeah. And on the other side, are they gone with Bonner Maher after Declan Hannan? Is that why he's in there? He hasn't started as many games in the past. Is that Cal saying that we want to see, can we go at them? And Hannan, he's been an outstanding player, outstanding captain, but a bit like Limerick over the last couple of games, hasn't been at his very best.
What do you make, though, of the fact, Donal Logue, that there is this change to the goalkeeper? So we see young Rhys Shelley is coming in. He's making his championship debut. Now, he did feature during the league campaign, but to come in and get your championship debut against the All-Ireland champions and coming up against the likes of Gillan and Flanagan.
Well, it's the one way to find out about a fellini if he's got the belly for it. But look, he's been around. Liam Cahill has worked with him at underage level. He has played games already at senior level. Like, to be fair to Barry Hogan, he didn't do that much wrong in the last game. I know he commented on his puckouts that maybe there was something in terms of the hang time, and maybe Shelley, I was even watching him striking the ball there, him having a much shorter hang time, that could be the difference. But it's a very tight call no matter what happened.
What you're seeing here now is obviously the toying cost, but the coin toss, but what happened before that is that Declan Hannan is presenting Lo McGrath there with the official jersey that has the Dylan Quirk Foundation on it. As we should all know at this stage, the two counties had agreed that they would both wear, instead of having sponsors, they would have this, the Dylan Quirk Foundation, across their jerseys for this afternoon's game in memory of this young man who lost his life on this very field, were playing the game he loved last August. New rule passed in March decided that this was not allowed. No no charities are allowed on. You're allowed to have corporations on, you're allowed to have multinational corporations on your jersey, but the sanctity of the jersey ends there when it comes to putting something like the Dylan Quirk Foundation, which aim is to create more cardiac screening for young GAA players so that what happens to Dylan doesn't happen to more young players.
Yeah, well, Joanne, did you ever hear debate with really, like, not allowing this? I know, bringing a rule or something, but this young lad, top lad, you know, his father before him, his uncle Declan Ryan, you know, I played in this fixture last year and we lost him tragically, and all the family in the club want to do is good for other families and other clubs and other potential players all over the country, and then the GAA won't let them go ahead with it. I don't know, sometimes some of the stuff baffles me.
Yeah, it's a horrendous decision, like, that they can't support this. It's a joke, really, how they've come up with this decision by the GAA and not allowed it to happen. And fair play to Tip and Limerick. They are trying different ways of trying to promote the Dylan Quirk Foundation by their bibs. If you notice all their bibs that they're playing with there, and you see the big flag there on the terrace as well.
Let it be a kick to everyone that's watching and everyone that's here, Joanne, to support it. And I know there's a jersey appeal on at the moment, and I can't find an old jersey that they're trying to sell. I'm going to come up with one from somewhere, I'll tell you that.
That's it. Turn it into a positive. Yeah, right?
And absolutely.
Like, in terms of making, hurling is bigger than a sport, right? For all of us.
Yeah.
It is, right?
Yeah.
The GAA is meant to be bigger than a sport. But that doesn't matter. That decision isn't in line with those values by the association.
Okay, yeah. So we're all thinking of Dylan Quirk today. We're all thinking of Dylan's family as well. So instead of perhaps getting predictions of this match, let's go over now and join our commentary team, Michael Dignan and Marty Marcy.
Thank you very much, Joanne. Let's take a look at the final teams here in this Munster Championship match. There are four significant changes to the Tipperary team that face Cork. It starts with the goalkeeping position, as Rhys Shelley is selected between the posts for this crucial clash. Barry Hogan was the goalkeeper for the games against Clare and Cork. Michael Breen has adapted well to life at full-back, although many will recall his debut against Limerick in 2015 when he scored a goal against the Shannonsiders at the other end of the field. This afternoon, he's Cathal Barrett and Ronan Maher in the corners. Brian O'Mara is a top-class hurler. The Holy Cross Ballycahill man has already won minor and under-20 All-Ireland medals. Owen Connolly at 5 is the second change the manager Liam Cahill has announced. Man of the match against Cork, Alan Tynan, has a new centre-field partner in Burris Elise's Dan McCormick. It's a midfield combination that has huge potential. Interestingly, Patrick Bonner-Marr is selected at centre-forward, with Conor Stakelum at number 10. Noel McGrath is transferred from centre-field to left-half forward. Gerard O'Connor is transferred to the edge of the square, with Mark Keogh, who made a huge impact when introduced against Cork, getting the left corner-forward jersey.
Yeah, Marty, you mentioned Alan Tynan, man of the match the last day. Brilliant against Cork. Was going to play rugby with Munster, but decided to throw in his lot of Tipperary hurlers. Himself and Will O'Donoghue had a ferocious start to the match last day, but I wouldn't be surprised if Darragh O'Donovan picked them up today in a man-marking role, because I think Limerick will want Will O'Donoghue in the game more rather than getting into a battle with Alan Tynan in the middle of the field.
Let's have a look at Limerick. Like a good wine, Nicky Quaid is getting better with age. He was outstanding against Clare in their last outing. Sean Finn's injury is a big blow to the Limerick defence, but John Kiley is lucky to be able to call on Mike Casey to join Dan Morrissey and Barry Nash in the Shannonsiders' inside line. They really have established themselves as the best half-back line in the country, as Dermot Burns, Declan Hannan and Kyle Hayes stand up and stand together to another championship challenge. The same compliment can be paid to the Limerick centre-field partnership of Darragh O'Donovan and William O'Donoghue. As Tina Turner would say, simply the best. Great to see Keane Lynch starting today, as thankfully his hamstring is fully recovered, so he's back and will wear number 11. Another man on the first 15 is Gerard Hegarty, who didn't start against Clare. Full forward Seamus Flanagan is on fire this summer and has scored 3 goals and 2 points in just 2 matches. Aaron Gillan and now Carl O'Neill, who replaces Peter Casey, will keep him company in that attacking inside line that have the ability to win games on their own.
Yeah, Gerard Hegarty didn't start. A lot of nonsense rumours going around during the week. This happens, I suppose, at this time of the year. But these three players, Hegarty, Lynch and Morrissey, have been key to Limerick's success over the last number of years. And I think their battle with a relatively inexperienced half-back line with Owen Connolly and Brian O'Mara. Seamus Kennedy has been around a while. Connolly and O'Mara knew enough to championship hurling. How they cope with that half-forward line, to me, will be the key to this game today.
Well, the computations are just mind-boggling in so many ways. At the moment, it's Clare on 6 points, Cork and Tipperary on 3, and Limerick on 2. If Tipperary win, they qualify for the All-Ireland with a guaranteed place in the top 3. If Limerick win, well, then it's all up for grabs with the other 2 places and the vital games next weekend, Cork against Limerick and Tipperary against Waterford. absolutely packed Simple Stadium with Sean Stack from Parnell's club in Dublin. His dad, of course, is Sean Stack, who was part of the third team that won the league in 77 and 78. Game is on. Munster Championship. Limerick go into the attack with the very first ball. Going deep. Opportunity of a score to open after just 10 seconds of play. Guess who? Aaron Gillard.
Yeah, simple ball. Maybe another day he could have taken it on and went for the goal. What a cracking atmosphere, Marty. I don't know what's in here. The guts of 40,000. Real Munster Championship hurling and a huge game ahead of us, I hope.
Not a puff of wind, no rain, a little bit cloudy overhead, but certainly loads of sunshine to keep us all warm on this particular May Sunday. Sideline ball going to Tipperary. You know all the computations. It really is a crucial Munster Championship match. A province that has given us so many storylines, so many twists and turns, and there is still more to come. Sent in by Noel McGrath. You have to love it. Scored 3 points against Clare, twice an All-Star. He's just a special talent at 32 years of age.
Brilliant skill, we expect nothing less. I nearly knew he'd put it over when he lined it up. Not much more we can say about that man at this stage.
Breaking ball picked up this time by Conor Stakelham. Hand passes into the centre over towards Seamus Kennedy, who was outstanding against Cork, scoring some crucial points. Fantastic atmosphere around the town of Thurles. It might only be a Munster Championship match rather than a Munster hurling final, but the neighbours are clashing. The people are talking, they're slagging each other off, and they just simply love what we're going to see here.
Yeah, and this is what you can't do against Limerick, is carry the ball into the tackle, carried in, held up there by Mike Casey, and then judged at throwing the ball, which he did.
Dermot Byrne's going to take this. Has already scored 8 points in the championship campaign. 2 frees against Waterford, 3 in total, and all of the frees, all 5 of them against Clare. And Dermot Byrne's going for his first score of the match here in Thurles, but that one is wide. Brees Shelley from Moycarkey Boris going short, fires one in Maher. Delivering the long ball. Declan Hannan in there at number 6. Coming looking for it is Mark Hill. Made an impression when introduced against Cork. Using the short grip because he knew he was going to be hooked. And batting that over the bar. Good score.
Yeah, and this guy has huge potential. His biggest thing is his pace. Lightning pace, did well, shortened the grip. Hegarty being dragged off the ball here.
There's a tussle. Chill
standing
it
inside as well. Keane Lynch is at full forward, Conor Neal out centre forward.
Kyle Hayes going forward as Dan McCormack and Gerard Hegarty have got on with it momentarily. Nipping in is Seamus Kennedy. There's a foul on the Tipperary man. And it's one of those games that you can hardly hear yourself speak. There was such a volume of noise.
Yeah, brilliant block down here. On Keane Lynch. Dan McCormack has come back right half back. He was picked in the middle of the field. Very, very physical player. He's going to pick up Hegarty wherever he goes. Brilliant atmosphere here. Plenty of off the ball stuff. Nothing too serious. Galan is getting plenty of chat up there. So is Seamus Flanagan. That's what you'd expect from a decent fullback line.
Rhys Shelley going to take the free. Just outside his own 45 metre line. Hits it powerfully. The crowd lock. Good. And the blue and gold will blow in the breeze here. Good score, and that will give that young goalkeeper, student in University of Limerick, a huge boost.
It will, it'll give Liam Cahill a huge boost as well. Big call to pick him, beautiful score.
Great catch, Tom Morrissey. Morrissey is fouled. Alan Tynan is saying he was going for the ball, but Sean Stack is indicating.
Yeah, brilliant catch here by Morrissey. He has been absolutely outstanding, maybe when Limerick not at their best. Just a little flick in there. He probably thought he was going to pass it with him, a little flick. Nothing serious, but is a free.
Second free for Dermot Burns. Concentrating on the job at hand. Hits it well, and this time the umpire will raise the white flag. Normal service has just resumed for the Patrick Swell man. Again, Rhys Shelley goes long. Batted down. Rod Hegarty just slipping at the time. Forcing Dan McCormack out over the sideline. I think we're going to see more of this going on. Keane Lynch is just giving him a little hello as McCormack was passing. Sideline cut, Darragh Donovan, but it goes wrong from a Limerick point of view. The Tipperary man had to earn his free. He got there eventually. The whistle was blown, and it's free for the Premier County. William O'Donoghue eventually stopping his opposite number nine, Dan McCormack.
Yeah, Dan McCormack very, very strong there. Broke through the tackle, was being held back. But Hegarty has gone back to the other wing now, and McCormack is after him again. So that's going to develop into a serious battle for the rest of the afternoon.
Ex-minor and under 20 keeper. Going for it again. Boosted by the first shot. This one goes well wide. Puck out from Nicky Quaid. Dropping down towards Keane Lynch and company. Picked up by Ronan Maher. Flicking it forward. Intercepted. Tom Morrison. Keane Lynch. Little flick of the wrist. Trying to get a ball in towards Big William. Keane Lynch is available for the pass. Looking at the post. And it goes wrong side of the post, much to the relief of the Tipperary fans. But that really was a scorable position for a player of the quality of Keane Lynch. Tackles are going in ferociously. Even some lads are colliding with each other from the same team. Declan Hannon thrusting forward, allowed no space. Over for Tom Morris, a quick hand, as far as Dermot Burns. 1 point from a frame. Two wides now. He'll be disappointed as well.
He will, Marty. A couple of uncharacteristic wides just shows you everyone is human. A lot of pressure on here today. Tipperary trying to carry the ball out. This heavy traffic that you're always going to get from Limerick. Not easy to win those balls in tight spaces.
Breaking ball favours Tipperary. Knocked away. Paul O'Neill did well. Seamus Flanagan got an old-fashioned shoulder from Carl Barrett, and the crowd absolutely love it. Thou shalt not pass the 11th commandment down in Tipperary, and Carl Barrett implemented it. It was not quite shoulder to shoulder, I have to say, when you look at it from that camera perspective, but he got away with it.
Yes.
Tight marking, Carl Barrett.
Sorry, Marty, I say Seamus Flanagan probably had overcarried as well, maybe that's why the referee didn't judge it to be in the back.
Ronan Maher cut it in beautifully. Declan Hannon having to go back to gather. Nicky Quaid is available. He's under pressure from Bonner Maher. Hannon coming out with it. Still Bonner Maher. Battling in there is Noel McGrath. There's the Bonner. Trying to get away from the shackles of Hannon and company. Referee blows his whistle. He's given a free. He's picked there for a reason, Patrick Bonner Maher. He's showing the determination that he showed in training already in this match, which is just 8.5 minutes old.
And exactly, Marty, I was going to say it. That's why he's there. We've seen it so many times over the years. What a warrior. He started inside in the full forward and right corner forward. Gareth O'Connor has gone out to centre forward. Changes all over the place. But that's what Bonner Maher brings to a team, that relentless work rate and attitude. A ball winning ability.
Gareth O'Connor gets his first easy free. And it is important, considering that they're missing a certain Mr. Ford in Tipperary, that Gareth, from a Tipperary perspective, starts with an easy one, and that's exactly what that was. Short puck out, far as Barry Nash, sending it down the wing. Over towards William O'Donoghue. Ronan Maher just arrived, it picked up by Noel McGrath. He always seems to have so much space, so much time, laying it off swiftly, efficiently, effectively, and very effectively indeed. Beautiful Tipperary movement with Jake Morris getting his name on the score sheet for the first time.
That's brilliantly worked, and Noel McGrath, the ultimate link man, beautiful pass, but Morris is playing brilliantly. He's really come of age this season, used his pace, made room for himself, great score.
Barry Nash to Darragh Donovan. Declan Hannon. floating one in for Seamus Flanagan. Tipperary trying to attack the ball. Flanagan getting away. Back there too is Conor Stakeham. And that is over the bar. A battle that's going to go on, that's going to be interesting, is between the Limerick full forward, this man, Seamus Flanagan, and Conor Stakeham, and indeed Michael Breen.
Yeah, and Conor Stakeham getting back there, maybe made sure there was no goal chance. He made huge strides to get back, covered 40, 50 yards.
Long ball from Brian O'Mara. Bunch of charge, they collided with each other. And Bonamara is feeling the pain as much as what Dermot Burns is. And bloody nose there means that he'll definitely be getting medical attention. Dermot Burns took a heavy challenge there from Patrick Bonamara.
If you watch Dermot, he turns back into him. And I'm not sure it was anti-malicious, but a lot of these we're talking about has become a huge topic over the summers, the head-high tackles. A lot of them, you know, very, very dangerous. I think, to be fair to Bonamara there, he is very physical in the tackle, but Dermot Burns, you can see, he turned straight back into him and, you know, he hadn't really got room to move out of the way. Very, very heavy hit and two tough men.
John Kiley has played such a crucial role in Limerick's dominance over the last number of seasons. Tipperary introduced Seamus Callanan.
Not a bad sub.
Great sub to have. Liam Cahill. Very much changing and tweaking, not afraid to make those big calls. First year, of course, in charge of his native county.
What a job he's done, Marty, with all the players that are missing through injury.
Ball dropping in. Great hands. Good hands. Brian O'Mara has really impressed me in this Munster Championship campaign. Testing ball for the Limerick defence. But as usual, or as normal, they come away with it. Kyle Hayes. Flick on, he's gone for the return pass. Great block down. Full marks by Owen Connolly. Picked up by Mark Keogh, out in the middle of the field. Advantage being given. Still Keogh. Referee blows the whistle. But the hits are going in.
This is great stuff. It's great stuff from Tipperary. What blocking, hooking, the pace that Liam Cahill seems to be able to bring to all these teams, Marty, as well. But great block down by Owen Connolly, as you say. The ref gave the advantage. I know people would say, why did he let him go on? But if they didn't get a score out of it, you know, they now will have a free shot at the post.
Patrick Bonamara has got the band-aid on, helmet back on, and ready for action. Meanwhile, Gerard O'Connor is going to take his second free. A little bit more of a challenge this time. The young player from Moyne Temple Toohey. He got the first one, which was near enough, and he's got the second one as well. 2 points.
Number 11,
O'Connor, as Patrick Bonamara comes back on. He was twice an All-Star, remember, 2014 and 2016. Man who made his debut against Wexford way back in 2010. Jamie Cannon, an All-Ireland winning captain. Great substitute to have. Batted away on this occasion into the path of Tom Morrissey, heading towards the sideline. Little jersey pulled by Conor Stakeham. Referee said play on, but there was nothing developing from that. Ball is wide.
And Tip had the ball out again. They're really moving the ball quickly. Nolan McGrath just stepped out over the line there. Just some of Limerick shooting so far. They just seem to be maybe feeling the pressure. We saw Keane Lynch, we saw Dermot Burns, and then Tom Morrissey there having three poor wides by their standards.
Keane Lynch and Seamus Kennedy are determined to have a chat, if you want to describe it like that. More of a physical confrontation that has now whittled out to zero. And sideline ball going to be taken by Dermot Burns. Half blocked. Picked up by Brian O'Mara. All-Ireland minor medalist 2016, developing into a fine senior player. Barry Nash is unmarked, gives it quickly to Kyle Hayes, skips away from the challenge. Quick hands again, Hayes is available. In comes Colin O'Neill, on the Tipperary 65. Floats it very high and floats it between the posts and over the bar. Great play by Colin O'Neill.
Yeah, and that's what Limerick do very well. Nash to Hayes, to Hannon, to O'Neill. There was good tackles coming in from Tipper. They evaded them. Here's a short hook out gone wrong now.
Limerick snapping on any loose ball. There was a chop down there on Aaron Gillan by Owen Connolly. So that's going to be a free for Limerick.
Yeah, a little bit of inexperience shown. There was no danger, actually. Gillan had turned a little bit into trouble there. He'd nowhere to go. He just dropped the ball to the ground and kind of drew the foul from Owen Connolly.
John Kiley and Kyle Hayes just having a little word there. It gives you a pretty good idea of the perspective that's facing Dermot Burns from our camera down there. Lovely shot. So let's see what Dermot Burns can do from here. Looking good from our position, and it's straight over the black spot. ...16 minutes gone. Rhys Shelley with the puck out. Breaking ball picked up nicely by Conor Stakelam. Under pressure from Carl O'Neill, still Conor Stakelam. Limerick put the pressure on. Tom Morrissey to Kyle Hayes, grabbed it the second time. Fair shoulder, just went a little bit into Tipperary territory. Carl O'Neill has misjudged this, has he? No, he hasn't. Great score, Carl O'Neill. Second point in a row from the Limerick man.
Yeah, this is a brilliant underage player. He really has had to take his time to get into the starting team, with the forward they have with Peter Casey, but O'Neill absolutely on fire.
And the puck out goes astray again, goes straight to Carl O'Neill. Floats this in. Michael Breen is back there. Has the time to turn, send it down towards Ronan Maher. Long ball. Could work out okay for the Premier County. Flicking it back. Score on the way. And it's a good one. Off the stick of Jake Morris.
Yeah, simple stuff. Lovely pass out there by Mark Yeo. Two yellow helmets combined. Lovely ball by Ronan Maher up the wing into space.
Ball is intercepted by Jake Morris. Could he get two in a row? Yes, he can. Brilliant play. That's 3 points for the Nina-year-old player. Very sharp. His league form has continued on in the championship. Remember, he scored 2-4 against Clare in the Cusick Park opener down in Ennis. Sideline ball to Tipperary. Is it a concern, Michael Dignan, considering that Rhys Shelley was selected, I think, primarily for the puck outs, because they analysed the video after the Tipperary-Cork game, and I think that was part of the reason why the Tipperary goalkeeper from Waikiki Boris got the selection, got the nod.
Yeah, he's a lovely striker. You can see that with his free taking as well. I think a bigger concern on the Limerick side would be their full back line. Sean Finn, I know they have a brilliant team, but Sean Finn, a massive loss, and you can see that already. Jack Morris, 3 points off Mike Casey so far.
Loose ball. Barry Nash going to deal with the situation. Feeds Darrow Donovan. Not going to hand cleanly. William O'Donoghue has to lay it away. Kyle Hayes, the All-Ireland champions, combining nicely. Barry Nash under pressure sends the ball well wide of the target.
Here tip come again. They're just the quick puck outs are just unbelievable, putting Limerick under all sorts of pressure.
Aiming from Mark Hill. Dermot Burns, slither in hand. Declan Hannon. Darrow Donovan, nicely sidestepped by the Dune man. Keane Lynch, William O'Donoghue. Took his eye off it, works out all right. Here's Tom Morrissey, floating it in over his left shoulder. And that is going straight between the post and over the bar. Tom Morrissey, from the great club of Ahan. A club that produced way back in time the wonderful Mick Mackey.
Just coming up in the 20th minute, tip after a load of hurling. And just 1 point off this Limerick team are unbelievable.
Dermot Burns has loads of time. Carl O'Neill looking sharp. You can see why he got first team selection. The race for position here in possession. And out over the sideline. Same as Flanagan. Just a little bit unlucky, but staying with him.
Yeah, well, he was being held off the ball. Cathal Barrett, his two arms around him inside the square. He was trying to make the run, he couldn't get away. The ref looked in and actually saw it and just chose to ignore it. And that's very, very frustrating for Seamus Flanagan. That's Cathal Barrett doing what he had to do.
Brian O'Mara, first season on the championship side. Went to USA last year in a J1, but he's a huge bonus to Liam Cahill's team. Dermot Burns gets there. 5-5. Tussle is won by Owen Connolly. He's gone for the return pass. Great one. There's only one thing on his mind. It's Mark Gill. And that's the score. It's the second point of the game. And between them, the full forward line for Tipperary have now scored 7 points.
Yep. 5 from play and the 2 frees. And just that energy that Limerick always had, you know, it just seems to be, you saw there Tom Morrissey and Dermot Burns, both of them really should have got to the ball, but they didn't.
Long puck out again by Nicky Quaid. Tipperary very much alert to the ball. They always went down to Garrod Hegarty. Little jink by Jake Morris, going right, left. Puts the slipper up into the air and connects with the boss of the hurling. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful hurling by Jake Morris. Look at the jig, look at the sidestep. Flung it up into the air and let it fly.
And, you know, we saw this with Jake Morris as an underage player, but it has taken a while. And that's only natural, it does take a while. But he is absolutely giving an exhibition out there in the first 21 minutes of this game. And, you know, look at that zip, look at the fitness levels of Tipperary. I'd heard stories about them training before Christmas and what they were doing. And it was tough running.
A little bit of concern here as Nicky Quaid seems to be in a spot of bother. And they're obviously holding up the play to make sure that the goalkeeper in his 12th season as number one will be able to continue on. John Kennedy's looking on. Liam Cahill is also wondering what's going to happen with Nicky Quaid. Just seems to have picked up an injury in some shape or form. He looks just a little bit winded. Primary school teacher in Patrick's Well, twice an All-Star. And his late father, of course, Tommy, what a goalkeeper he was. He played in the 1980 All-Ireland final against Galway. But to lose Nicky Quaid for any reason whatsoever would be a huge blow to John Kiley and to Limerick, but he seems to be okay. He mightn't be feeling that well. It's hard to judge. I don't think he picked up any injury. We wish you well, Nicky. We hope you can continue on. Takes the puck out down the middle. The Road Hegarty just can't grab it. Slither sent at speed down towards Patrick Bonner-Marr. Little hand pass. Jake Morris, but referee Sean Stark felt it was a throw. And that is a free out for Limerick.
It's probably the inconsistency of these that's killing. Liam Cahill is going mad. You know, that's the first one we've had since the start of the game.
Now, was it a throw?
It looked like a hand pass to me. Looked like a clear hand pass.
Dermot Burns taking the free. It's a good ball. Keane Lynch. Kept away from goal. Double mark momentarily. He's without a hurley. He has the slither. Hand passes it on. Aaron Gillard. The two Patrick Swell lads combined. And that is over the bar. Gillan will get the credit for scoring, but we must also acknowledge the great work of Keane Lynch without a hurley here, and still had the composure to give it to his clubmate and teammate to score. Disappointed handling by Declan Hannon. That's not normal. William O'Donoghue giving it to Barry Nash. Sending it over towards Dermot Burns. Not everything being perfect by Limerick, Michael. Some of the handling would be a disappointment to John Kiley. Clash of the Ash goes off of Limerick hurley, says the linesman, and that's going to be a sideline ball for Tipperary.
Yeah, I'm just looking at the Tipperary rotation in the forwards. Jake Morris has been at centre forward, and maybe he has been there for some of his scores. Alan Tynan was wing forward. Now Noel McGrath's gone in. They're moving all over the place. They're not alone. Tipper or Limerick to man mark any of them, and they're causing, that's where they're creating the room from. And as I said a few minutes ago, you know, Limerick hanging in there, they're living on scraps, but they're just staying in the game.
Ronan Mahan with the sideline cuts, and as always, it's a good one down towards Bonamar, chasing after it, getting away from Declan Hannan on this occasion. Barry Nash takes up responsibility, and that's a free in. Harry might argue that Bonner, I think, was diving. I don't think so. I think that was a legitimate foul on the Tipperary centre forward. Yellow card for the corner back.
He just used all his experience. He always tell the forward, look, duck inside. He drew the foul. Barry Nash pulled him down. There's no complaints there.
I love this camera angle. Feels like we're right behind, down the sideline with Gerard O'Connor as he lifts and strikes and puts that over the bar.
Limerick have had no free in their own half. Gillan hasn't taken a free. Just shows the discipline at the back, so maybe they're getting away with a few.
A little bit of holding.
Eventually given one.
Gerard Hegarty was being held. Sean Stack saw it this time. And that's why there was a big cheer from the Limerick fans. But Hegarty finally got a free.
It is important, though, for the forward, Marty, that the ref does pick up one or two of those, because otherwise the back will continue to hold, and in fairness, you wouldn't blame them. But Hegarty's green helmet on there as well, problem with the first one.
Well, you were just mentioning the fact that Limerick have yet to receive a free in this half, and rightly so in some ways. But they have one now, and Aaron Gillan just got over the bar for his third point of the game.
No, Tip have been hugely disciplined. They're hunting in packs. We saw a couple of great lockdowns already. Ferociously committed and very, very well prepared Tipperary team.
Rhys Shelley is looking at his options. Could go short, but decides to go long down the wing. Good hands. Good play. And this time, Jake Morris is deemed to have fouled the possession. That's going to be a free for Limerick.
Yeah, and he's getting a bit of afters there from Limerick. Realise how important he's been in the game so far. He took a brilliant take there. It's a long way away from us here on the angle.
Was it a free?
And he turned in and went at Burns. Burns stood his ground. This is the thing. Mostly they're given, you know what? But the referee chose that he overcarried it. Probably harsh on him, but Dermot Burns would say he stood his ground and held him up.
Dermot Burns going to take this again. His free taking is such a crucial part in this successful Limerick team. It's dropping from the sky. The crowd don't particularly like it. The ball is wide. It's the sixth wide of the match for Limerick. In comparison to Tipperary's just one. Well, far sharper up front in terms of their scoring chances or taking them. Rhys Shelley, better ball this time to Ronan Marr. Ball to hand, Seamus Kennedy delivers it long. It's a good ball too. In comes Patrick Bonner-Marr, sniffing around for the loose breaking ball. Dan Morris, he gives it to Nicky Quaid. And he took it, was he outside the square? I think this could be a free. It could be worse, what is it? And the referee has indicated that it is a free for Tipperary. Sean Stack is telling Gerard O'Connor calm down. Noel McGrath is having his word of advice for the referee as well, but he has already made up his mind.
Yeah, it's a technical free for lying on the ball. Something not fully right with Nicky Quaid, as you mentioned earlier, Marty, not like him to make any sort of a mistake ever. And just one or two of his puck outs, and there again, his handling, not what you'd expect from one of the greatest goalies we've seen.
Gerard O'Connor going to take this. Satisfied, I would imagine, with almost a half an hour play to just tap it over the bar for his fourth point. This was the incident again as the ball was passed back. Nicky Quaid just took his eye off it. Seemed to lie in the ball just on the line or maybe inside it. Tom Morrissey having a pop, having a go, and scored it. Second point of the match for Tom Morrissey. Limerick stay in touch.
No, brilliant score, and he has been the one player against Clare as well, defiant all the way through, having a fantastic season.
Have to note as well, Michael, that the puckouts from Rhys Shelley have improved as the game went on. They're far more razor-like, going straight to the intended target.
They are, and I think in fairness to him, it was more that the lads as well were losing possession or getting caught in the tackle, but you just see Limerick tackled so hard, it's on the border all the time, and Sean Stack has judged that one to be a foul, whereas maybe the previous one wasn't. It's just very, very hard to call it.
Gerard O'Connor has come all the way back to his own half of the field, as you can see, between the 45 and 65. This one dropping short. A little touch required, but Nicky Quaid is there. Dermot Burns is waiting for the ball, which he shouldn't do. And Tipperary are really hungry, giving it back, trying to make a bit of space. Good work by Jake Morris. He gets away from the challenge, confident to take them all on. He stopped on the 20-metre line, and that is a free in for Tipperary. But the hunger is there for all to see. Limerick waiting for the ball, Tipperary chasing the ball. And we've had a few sequences of that in the game. Yellow card for Dermot Burns.
Well, you have two of their backs on yellows now, Barry Nash and Dermot Burns. And credit Noel McGrath there again. You'll be saying as a young lad, don't wait for the ball. Dermot Burns waiting in nips Noel McGrath. And Jake Morris, despite the fact he was caught in possession a couple of times, took on his man again and headed for the goals, won the free. And Tipperary, maybe the scoreline maybe reflecting their dominance. You know, they should hardly be a little bit more up.
Fifth point of the match for Gerard O'Connor. A lot of them are easy enough frees, which would be good for him on this important day. Kyle Hayes. Difficult ball for him to pick up, and they're double marking. Patrick Bonner-Marr rolls the slither up on the hurley, pulled on first time. Good to see Connor Stakeland. Barry Nash looking for this Carl O'Neill. Jake Morris coming into challenge, hits it up high, drops it down towards the full forward line where Gerard Hegarty is hovering. Tipperary defensively looking strong. Connor Stakeland lets fly with the slither. Doesn't matter where it goes, really, from his point of view, just get it out of the danger area. Picked up by Mike Casey, going down the middle channel, down towards William O'Donoghue. Skips away from the challenge being provided by Tipperary. Carl O'Neill floating this one in, and floating it literally on top of the net and over the bar. That's 3 points for Carl O'Neill. He's playing well.
Yeah, he's playing really well. He's a super striker left or right, and that held just carried over the bar.
This time he goes short, Tipperary keeper. Then Rhys Shelley goes for distance, two against two. The reinforcements arrive, what a catch! The overlap is provided, and it's hit over the left-hand shoulder, and that is a thing of beauty. Mark Kill hitting the slither over the bar. Great, great catch, brilliant score.
And just the way Tipper mixing it up, you know, short, then a big long ball, isolating the big man inside, super ball. And that's 3 and 4 from Morris, 7.
What a catch by Dan McCormack, beating Gerard Hegarty. And then, oh, look at the applause from the Tipperary lads there, Ronan Marr and Alan Tynan saying, well done. Great catch, Dan McCormack.
Yeah, brilliant timing, and this is a master stroke so far by Liam Cahill. McCormack following Hegarty everywhere, all over the field. How many times over the years have we seen Hegarty drifting left and right, scoring goals and points at his ease? And just, we haven't seen a man-marking job like this on him in a long, long time.
Rhys Shelley dropping this one in, has the legs, nobody can get a touch, wide ball. Second wide of the match for Tipperary with about, what, 30-40 seconds to go to the break. Been very efficient up front. Great ball from Nicky Quaid to Tom Morrissey. Seamus Flanagan, Tipperary backs are there in numbers. Sending it straight down the middle. Just took his eye off it. Mark Hill picked up by Kyle Hayes. Saw the challenge was coming. Colin O'Neill quick flick outside towards Dermot Burns, dropping this in. Goalkeeper has all the time in the world to deliver it. Gives it short. Tipperary working themselves out of trouble. Ronan Maher. This is a good play by Tipperary. And Brian O'Mara at the end of it all. It would be a great point. If it goes over, it doesn't. But I have to say that you have to be impressed with the Tipperary defence. The way they're working out the ball, they're not panicking, they're very much in control.
Absolutely, Marty. And Carl Barrett's ability to get to the ball and break that ball is huge. And Ronan Maher picking up ball, loose ball all over the place. And a great striker then.
Declan Hannan rolling it along the surface. Little shimmy to the left. And then sent. Is it dropping? It is dropping over the bar, off the stick of Aaron Gillan. Good score for Limerick.
Well, he's unbelievable, Marty. He's only got three balls in his hand. He scored 3 points. He's got, you know, he's got so little. But the full forward lines on both sides, like Jake Morris, Mark Yeo, you know, Cathal O'Neill. I know he's playing centre. He has three scored as well. Some great score taking.
Tipperary full forward line between freeze and play have now scored 12 points. It's Limerick trying to find their rhythm. Mike Casey fouled the possession. Can't believe it, but we can really when you see the pictures. As he got himself into a spot of bother there. Great pass back to Mike from Mike.
Yeah, exactly. But you know, you'd be impressed as well with Tipperary's physicality. You know, they're really standing up to these tackles. But can they keep this going? This will put them three up. They probably deserve to be at least that up at half time if he scores it. But it's tough going, very warm out there. Can they keep this pace going into the game? But they're very impressive so far.
Gerald O'Connor going for his 6th point of the game. This one is far out and just a little bit of a challenge, but it's raised another white flag. He's done well, the Moyne Temple Toohey hurler. Puck out from Nicky Quaid. And the referee, Sean Stark from Parnells in Dublin, blows the half-time whistle. An intriguing contest with the All-Ireland champions facing a serious, serious challenge from their neighbours down the road and one of their great rivals. Surrounded by Clare and Tipperary, you can't beat the rivalry between the neighbours, and it's reflecting what we've seen here. Tipperary being kept out of the tunnel and leaving Limerick going in first. Rhys Shelley has scored a point from a free. His puckouts have certainly been fairly sharp overall. And Liam Cahill will be well pleased with his team as they go in for a half-time break. And certainly the crowd here thoroughly enjoying it. Half-time in Semple Stadium, Thurles. It's Tipperary 15 points, Limerick 12. We'll be right back.
In one word, Anthony, are Tip going to hang on?
I think they might. I don't know. Well, look, Limerick have confounded us before at the halftime break.
Well, 2 years ago in the third quarter, they outscored Tip 110 to 1 point. So it's a big 15 minutes coming up for both teams. Back to Michael and Marty.
Thank you very much, Joanne. And away we go. Second half is underway. As Limerick now playing from left to right, wondering how they're going to deal with this challenge. The All-Ireland champions playing a little bit too smart there from Aaron Gillan, as once again Owen Connolly got the pass. I think it was Carl Barrett that interrupted the flow. There's a little bit of afters there on Kyle Hayes' helmet, which was unnecessary, and Kyle reacted.
Yeah, and we're talking about the matchups, Marty. Alan Tynan on Kyle Hayes, trying to keep him quiet. I'd actually move Kyle Hayes up into the forwards if I was Limerick now, but John Kiley knows more than me about management. But Aaron Gillan should have put that over the bar, but a great interception by Cathal Barrett, very aware of what was happening around him.
I know you were saying to me at halftime you could bring in Colin Coughlin into wing-back and move Kyle Hayes up to the forwards. They have the players, obviously.
Yeah, well, Colin Coughlin is long enough around, he's top class. I think that would be a great move.
Anyway, let's deal with what we have. As the referee, Sean Stark, has blown his whistle for the challenge on Seamus Flanagan. Cathal Barrett will claim he was going for the ball. But Seamus Flanagan is still on the ground as Carl Barrett's name has now been taken. And that's going to be a yellow card. Let's see what happened here.
Yeah,
the Hurley was coming down here.
Marty, that's you know, borderline red card there. That's the rules. And I know maybe the ref's a long way away, couldn't see, but you interfere with the face card or go anywhere near the face card, that's a red card.
Yeah.
So I think Cathal Barrett, you nearly know by Cathal Barrett there, he was happy enough to take the yellow.
Aaron Gillan got 4 points in the first half. As you can see from that camera perspective, a little bit easier. This one taps that over the bar. Down to 2 points again. Rhys Shelley goes short. Easy ball, very easy ball for Kyle Hayes. Seamus Flanagan getting away from Cathal Barrett. Little flick on. Keane Lynch to Carl O'Neill, who's been on tremendous form in the first half. And that's 4 points from play. Very impressive. But he's been promising this for quite a while, coming up through the underage ranks. He will please. Look at John Kiley. He knows he needs the support of the Limerick fans. Nipping in. Tom Morrison. Darragh Donovan. Good vision. Liam Cowell is animated along the sideline to say where's the marker. And the crowd roar. The white flag will be raised. O'Neill is on fire. 5 points from play.
Yeah,
very, very impressive.
He's causing havoc with his movement. He's all over the pitch. But the previous goal came about from Ronan Marr tucking the ball straight down the middle to Kyle Hayes. You can feel the difference in Limerick. They're all energy, all drive. But Tipperary are going to have to retain possession way better. Here's another 50-50 hopeful ball up the field.
Sides are level. That didn't take very long, all about 3 minutes. Well, Ireland champions are accepting the challenge and they've raised the gear. Can Tipperary now equal it? Ball sent in by Noel McGrath. Icky Quay watches it all the way. Backs it clear. Declan Hannan down towards Kyle Hayes, has the goalpost in his sights, sends it long. Flanagan keeps it in play, picked up by Michael Breen, first to alert to this breaking ball, picked up here by Brian O'Mara. Quick hands, Dan McCormack from way out the field. Nicky Quaid coming out underneath it again. Good hands, Nicky Quaid. That's why you've been an all-star keeper and All-Ireland medalist. Very, very impressive, Kyle Hayes. Already, this is a lot better from the All-Ireland champions. Crossfield ball is aimed at Seamus Flanagan. He's going to go for it. He's going to try for it. And he's going to achieve it. Seamus Flanagan. Brilliant. With his second point of the match. It's a thing of beauty. From Nicky Quaid's catch at one end to Seamus Flanagan's point at the other end. This is Hurling at its very best.
And that's 4 points to nil since half-time. But the key man in that move for me was Garrod Hegarty. He's having a quiet game by his standards, but he's still there. That hurl was dropped there, the free wasn't given. Limerick are really tearing into it now.
William O'Donoghue without the Hurling. Tim McBarnes. They're going for it again, Keane Lynch. But this one swings to the right and wide for Limerick, seven wide of the game.
We'll just go back to the previous score. Hegarty got a ball on the sideline. The temptation must have been to have a go himself, but he picked out Darragh Donovan. He played a brilliant crossfield ball to Flanagan. Great score.
Brian O'Mara has picked up an injury. And himself and Rhys Shelley and Garrod O'Connor won 6 and 14, both part of the UL team that won the Fitzgibbon Cup. As we look at this ball sent in by Darragh Donovan to Seamus Flanagan. Watch this. Just watch this. Had a quick look and let it fly. Ah, fantastic. Over his right shoulder.
Yeah, I just saw, look, it's not a huge thing in the context of the game, but Hegarty just showed his experience there by playing the right ball, even though he was under pressure during the game.
Rhys Shelley goes long this time, batted away. Kyle Hayes to Darragh Donovan. He's gone for the return pass. Tracking back is Garrod O'Connor. They're facing a Limerick storm, Tipperary, at the moment. They have to withstand it. Are they able for that? Nipping away is Ronan Marr. Under pressure. It's floating to the left and it's floating wide for Tipperary's fourth wide of the game.
Marty, the optimum word there is pressure. That's what in the first half they were getting those shots away with no pressure. Now the pressure is coming from everywhere.
Garrod Hegarty in that typical Nicky Quaid Garrod Hegarty way, always trying to find him with the cutouts. Dan Morrissey beating Bonner Marra. Here comes Bonner! He never gives up. Oh. Patrick Bonner Marra. He was beaten out the gate here by Dan Morrissey. Now just watch this. Thank you very much.
Classic Bonner.
It gives Tipperary an opportunity here between the 45 and 65 to level the match again. This will be for the fourth time. Gerard O'Connor scored six in the first half. All of them frees from different angles. Steadying the ship, raising the white flag for his seventh. And the sides are level for the fourth time.
And that was needed, and that was brilliant from Bonner, brilliant leadership, and how many times have we seen that over the last 13 seasons?
Nicky Quaid this time aiming for Dan Morrissey. Skipping away, Tom Morrissey, I should say, as far as William O'Donoghue. There's Tom again, laying it back. Colin O'Neill's effort this time is half blocked, but does it have the legs? Rhys Shelley decided to put the hurley up. Sends it across the goal, there's confidence. As I was saying, these boys played with you well and they won the Fitzgibbon Cup. That's Brian O'Mara and Rhys Shelley. That familiarity is an advantage. Ball is sent in by Owen Connolly. Tipperary trying to stretch the Limerick defence here a little bit. Mark Kill sending it back, dead straight in front of the post, 45 metres out. Much better Tipperary. Lovely score from the Premier County. And off the stick of Noel McGrath for a second point.
And that's a great score, and God credit Tipperary now, they've really weathered the storm. They're a brilliant ball across the field to Noel McGrath, he doesn't miss from there.
Nicky Quaid into the path of William O'Donoghue. That area, that journey blocked for Big William, he goes the other direction. Comes far as Aaron Gallan, over his right-hand shoulder, but this time it's just off target. Eighth wide of the match for Limerick. Limerick pushing up on all the Tipperary defenders, although Owen Connolly is available. Goes down the middle. Quick ball, quick hands. Little flick on. Better from Tipperary. His own Connolly from Cashel King Cormac's drops this in, but he sends it wide. Disappointment for him. Quick puck out. There's no hanging around here. Declan Hannon coming in to help his wing back. Lovely pickup from the middle of the park. Hits this one and it's on its way. That's leadership. That's a captain, a real captain, that has lifted the Liam McCarthy Cup on several occasions. Beautiful.
What a catch by Kyle Hayes. And you mentioned Hannon. He was quiet in the first half. Everyone's powering into it, Marty. What a game of hurling. We have brilliant players on both sides. But look at this man here. Look at the power of him under the ball. That is unbelievable. And he's fouled there then on the way out.
Crossfield ball over far as Dermot Burns. The referee, however, has blown his whistle. I think he wants the free to be taken again. As the linesman actually is after moving in and saying the ball was not in the right place. Tipperary introduced Jamie Callanan. And a change means that Alan Tynan is the player that's coming off, who was outstanding against Cork, and Jamie Callanan, which means he'll go into the full forward line, and that'll mean a redesigning of the midfield area for the home side.
Yeah, his job is to keep Kyle Hayes out of the game. He did well in the first half, but Hayes has powered into the game since half-time, and obviously not an easy team to stay on Kyle Hayes for a game. I think I said it before, I probably would have retired if I was picked against him years ago. As a wing forward, I would not like to mark him.
Dermot Burns scored twice in the first half. This one is just dropping in. Square ball, free out for Tipperary. Rhys Shelley just about reaching Ronan Marr. A little bit tight, I have to say. If you're from Tipperary, you'll be having palpitations. William O'Donoghue looking around, giving a little bit of space. Intercepted, beautiful. Read the situation rather well. Back fires Noel McGrath from Jake Morris. Jake Morris, lovely stick work. The finish is just a little bit off. But it's the wrist work, it's the speed, it's the hand pass. It really is top notch.
Yeah, there's so little room out there. Maybe all a little bit tight there. Will O'Donoghue really should have got that ball away down the field. Good interception, and yet I think Limerick's discipline to tackle much better since half-time. They were giving away a lot of frees in the first half. We haven't seen that in the second.
Batted down on this occasion. Picked up by William O'Donoghue. Robbed and dispossessed. Lovely flick. In comes Tipperary again with the possession, but Aaron Gillan is available. So too is Carl O'Neill. Unselfishly trying to set up Gillan with a good ball inside into the corner. Half blocked as he crossed it back into the middle. Tipperary just a little bit exposed here. Little flick on from Declan Hannon. Paris Garrod Hegarty, former Hurler of the Year, on the 20, having a shot. That was a bit optimistic from there. I'm pretty sure he miscued it, because it would have been much wiser to tap that over the bar.
Well, he should have. You know, he hasn't scored yet. You'd imagine for himself, just for the... I mentioned earlier on, he was unselfish. I think that time took the wrong option.
Dermot Burns goes back to back him up the loose ball, sending it across towards Kyle Hayes. In the middle, unmarked, is Declan Hannon. Uses Garrod Hegarty. Hannon has gone for the return pass. Hits it from along the sideline, and that is gone right and wide. 10th wide of the match for Limerick.
Yeah, and a little bit like maybe Tipperary in the first half, missing a few chances. Limerick really should be a couple of points up now at this stage. They're dominating the second half, and crucial now, 10 minutes coming up in this game.
Reece Shelley again. They're not winning the puck out down there, as Kyle Hayes has really come to life. Lovely, beautiful stick work from Tom Morrissey, but then given away. Ronan Maher comes in, sends it down. That's a good ball. There's Garrod O'Connor in the middle of the park. Hits it powerfully, hits it awkwardly, hits it over the bar for his 8th point of the game and his first from play.
Yeah, if you watch Tip since the start of the game, they're trying to get the ball into Ronan Maher's hands in the back line. His distribution, brilliant, great point, great pass.
Puck out blocked. Well, Dermot Burns' effort was blocked. It's coming in with Seamus Kennedy. Darrow Donovan, work rate at the premium. Kyle Hayes, more prominent. Great block down, Tipperary. They're doing the essentials, the Premier County, hooking and blocking. Ball given away. That's not the essential, I can assure you. As Limerick gather the ball with Dermot Burns, aiming for Seamus Flanagan. Loose ball. Carl Barrett can't get there. Seamus Flanagan. Ah, what an intervention by Carl Barrett. And he's fouled. He was struggling to get up on his feet. And somehow he managed to get there. Bravely, courageously. He's suffering a little bit as a result of his efforts, but this looks like Limerick's opportunity. Somehow put the Hurley out, then comes in with the challenge here at Florida. Tom Morrissey coming in with a late challenge on the corner back from Holy Cross, Ballycow.
They're struggling to get the helmet off him here. First of all, Marty, the piece of play. You know, that, there was a goal on, goal written all over. What a cornerback Barrett has been. Tom Morrissey caught him on the side of the head. The referee doesn't seem to be taking any further action. He was closer to it.
Peter Casey is coming on for Limerick, and it looks like Keane Lynch is the player that's coming off. Referee Sean Stack is now going back in to check on the right corner back. Cahill Barish, who was Young Hurler of the Year back in 2014, All-Star cornerback in 2016. Tom Morrissey came in to challenge here. It was a wonderful pickup.
What you have here is Tom Morrissey did hit him in the head with his shoulder, but Cahill Barrett ducked in, and you know, and I'm not in any way trying to justify the hit to the head, but you know, that's the way Cahill Barrett plays. He ducks out, he's so brave, he looks to make that space by driving into it, and that's obviously why Sean Stack could judge it. But he took a very, very heavy knock. Tom Morrissey is a very strong man, one of the strongest on the Limerick team, and that could be the end of his afternoon. Keane Lynch off. Big call by John Kiley bringing in Peter Casey for him.
Keane Lynch off. Connor Bowe, by the way, is going to come on, I think, for Tipperary. Still concerned about Cathal Barrett. And he's a tight, tough corner back and doesn't feign injury, I can assure you.
Oh, he's a brilliant player. Like, he makes such a difference to Tip when he's on the field. He's had a few injuries over the last couple of years. The way he gets out in front.
Watch this.
This is Noel McGrath blocking down. It was three in a row there. Conor Stakeland went back and made a great block down as well. And then you saw the swing then with him coming up the field. Brilliant play. And that's the difference with Tipperary. They're working, they're hooking, they're blocking. The basics of the game, absolutely savage.
Conor Bow is on. Looks like Patrick Bonner Maher is the player that's making way. He's done his job. And he certainly gave it everything. Look at the Tipperary supporters giving him a standing ovation. Gives a little nod of the head to Liam Cahill. Now, it's up to Conor Bow to continue on the good work. Kyle Hayes going up for it. And Tipperary have it on the 20, laying it off. Chance of a shot here that goes inside the post and over the bar. And oh, we're going to Hawkeye, actually. Jake Morris obviously would say that it was over the bar, but we're requiring the services of Hawkeye here in Thurles.
The form he's in, it's hard to believe he could miss that, but
let's have a look at it here now. Every shot, every opportunity is crucial. Here it comes now. Sean Stack just indicating he's waiting for the decision on the screen. Hawkeye is now ready, I'm told. Here it comes. Is it a tall or is it a near? It's a tall. Inside the post with Jake Morris's fifth point of the game. Liam Cahill looks at his watch. 53 and a half minutes gone. They now lead by two. Short ball, far as Mike Casey. Dara Donovan. Jamie Callan chasing him. Noel McGrath. Tipperary just seem at the moment to have survived the Shannon Sider storm in the opening 5-10 minutes. Picked up here by Mark Hill. He knows only one thing. It's in the DNA and that's to go for scores. But this time he sends it wide. But he has scored three first half points. That's the point that we had to double check with Hawkeye, but look, to Beach was over the bar and Hawkeye agreed with us. Brian O'Mara. The ball is sent in and the ball is sent wide.
Yeah, you're dead right, Marty. We saw a brilliant start in the second half by Limerick, but Tip have weathered the storm. Look at Ronan Maher. Every time he's the man, maybe that one tucked away, but he has created havoc with some of those long clearances.
Barry Nash fires Dermot Barnes. Oh, that's a beautiful score. He hit it spot on. Two first half points from Freeze, complemented by his first point from play. Three in total, one between them. 55 minutes gone. Yes.
Now you can see that he's enough of the maybe ball going in, coming back out. He's saying, I'm going to take this on myself and no better man.
Oh, brilliant puck up by Rhys Shelley, finding Seamus Kennedy. On fires Noel McGrath. Little flick on is all that's required. It's Limerick chase, pursue. Great pressure. William O'Donoghue gets it away. Picked up by Tom Morrissey, Declan Hannan. Good ball, diagonal ball over to Seamus Flanagan. Cathal Barrett deals with it, hand passes it back. A little bit too fast for Ronan Maher. Nice little turn into the centre. Michael Breen. Connor Bow from Moyne Temple Toohey. Middle of the park. Hitting it powerfully. Hitting it superbly. Continuing on the good work of Patrick Bonner Maher is Connor Bow. Great score.
Yeah, he made a great movement off the ball, made loads of room for himself. A lovely ball out by Michael Breen and a great score.
Tom Morrissey again, trying to scoop it up. Reinforcements arrive with Conor Stakelum, number 10 for Tipperary. Still Morrissey trying to put his boot near it or at least over it. There's going to be a throw ball here between the 45 and 65. Full dot. Cahill O'Neill is the 25 for Limerick. Knocked away by Owen Connolly. Peter Casey adding a bit of sparkle. Seamus Flanagan is inside. Still Casey going forward, uses the short grip and sends it between the posts and over the bar. Seamus Flanagan was inside and available, but Peter Casey probably did the right thing. Well, we mentioned it earlier, and he's now coming on. That's Colin Coughlin from Ballybrown. It's good to be the player that's coming on. It's Rod Hegarty. It's actually Conor Boylan that's coming on. Picked up by Dermot Burns. Kyle Hayes. Darrow Donovan. Two against one. And an official who really shouldn't be there. Kept in, just about. There's still a player injured, that's why he's on. He's trying to get him off, but we continue on with the action. Trying to pick it up, trying to get a touch. Mark Hill. Should be a sideline ball for Barry Nash and Limerick. It's Cathal Barrett in the spot of bother again. This time the referee knows that the cornerback needs medical attention. That's what was happening at the time.
Well, it was bizarre there for the last couple of minutes. Cathal Barrett was walking around down there, as you say, with a medic with him. The ball in play, you can't play on, the player has the helmet on. I know at times lads are taking off their helmet to slow down the game, but this man has clearly got a bad heavy bang on the head a couple of minutes ago, and they're going to have to go in and see.
Seamus Flanagan is protesting, and he's protesting too much for the referee, who is now going to book the full forward, and he's showing him a yellow card. Flanagan is annoyed that he's saying that Cathal Barrett isn't as injured as he's pretending to be, but Cathal Barrett has now resumed his position.
Cathal Barrett is clearly, he was saying hurry up, he's in having a word. The Limerick, or the Tipperary physio is telling what he thinks of him as well, fairly clearly there, they can lip read. And
John Kiley and Paul Kinnerk, the dynamic duo of Limerick Hurling over the last number of years, facing another challenge. But Cathal Barrett is the player that's making way as Tipperary now introduce Brian McGrath, youngest brother of Noel and John.
How significant is this going to be? Because Cathal Barrett has been brilliant on, in general, on Seamus Flanagan. You saw a couple of the interceptions there as well during the game. This could be a huge turning point in the game.
Dan Morrissey sending it into the space to brother Tom. Runs by brother Tom and is sent back out. Connor Bow going again for glory. Oh, hello, Connor Bow. Under 20 All-Ireland medalist a few years ago with Liam Cahill. Cahill knows what he's capable of, and Bow has delivered spectacularly.
Beautiful, pure strike, fabulous score.
Here comes Peter Casey, giving it back first. Tom Morrissey, the referee, has blown his whistle. 21 points to 19. 10 minutes still to go.
And Martin, this is palpable. Yeah, it's massive in terms of the Munster Championship. It's also massive for Tipperary in the development. You know, they've lost a number of players this year. You heard the lads talk about Dylan Quirk before the game. Died here in the field so tragically last year. The foundation being honoured today, Dylan Quirk Foundation. You have Craig Morgan, you have Taddy Cadell. You have Jason Ford today, you have all these players missing, and yet Tipperary are hurling like this. Fantastic.
Aaron Galland going for his sixth point. Coming into this game, he's already scored 14 times. Seven against Waterford, seven against Clare. Graham Mulcahy coming on for Limerick. Player that's going off is Seamus Flanagan. Change in the Limerick attack.
Sorry, more I said to do with the yellow card, Marty, going to take a chance on another one.
Limerick have it. fall in. And that is a pretty good effort, but Rhys Shelley watched it all the way. Limerick with the possession. William O'Donoghue to Declan Hannan. Back to Hannan again. About to be challenged by Owen Connolly. Good work by the number five.
Yeah, Declan Hannan has been in the game way more in the second half, but fumbled that ball again, a little bit uncharacteristic. Left the last one into the goalie, and you can see him just a little fumble there. But Owen Connolly again, another block down by Tipperary.
Quickly rolled along. Farris William O'Donoghue sent it back. Farris Tom Morrissey. It's looking good. It's a great score. It really is. Just a few metres in from the sideline. Difficult angle. You can see how close he was to the sideline. This is third point of the game. And the sides are level again for the sixth time.
Yeah, William O'Donoghue, another man who's had a powerful second half. Simplicity, that score. Simple hurling, brilliant finish.
Brian O'Mara. First touch here, vital. Tipperary work it back towards Owen Connolly. Seamus Kennedy having a go, but sending that to the right and wide. Disappointment for the wing back.
He's now playing wing forward or corner forward. He's following. So I think he's got actually pushed up on Kyle Hayes. He's actually trying to mark Declan Hannan. He has moved into the half forward.
Brilliantly caught, superb. Great catch by Ronan O'Mara. Ronan O'Mara sent on, just skipping by Mark Hill. Advantage Limerick. Darragh Donovan to Kyle Hayes. Going for the score, but it's an easy ball to allow Rhys Shelley to just escort it out over the end line. 7 minutes to go. Sides level 21 each. David Reedy coming on for Limerick.
Carl O'Neill's been brilliant, but he's obviously out on his feet. 63 minutes, hard senior championship hurling, 5 from play. What a contribution.
Massive, massive game. Carl O'Neill, all of them from play. Barry Nash seems to have been fouling his opponent, but I'd like to look at this again. He is climbing all over.
He's wrapped around him.
Gerald O'Connor has been the model of consistency with his frees. A lot of talk, obviously, with the huge loss Jason Ford was, but so far, this man has done well. That's the angle. He's on the 45-metre line or just beyond it. Hits it, follows through. It looked like Shane Lowry would if he was playing a hurling game. Good score.
He has been brilliant on the frees. He stepped up, he hasn't missed any.
Carl Barrett looking on anxiously now, can't contribute anymore as Richie English is brought on by John Kiley. Puck out goes astray, slipping and sliding now. A little drop of some rain falling here in Simple Stadium. Barry Donovan saw the pass was going across. Noel McGrath, great vision! What a ball! Noel McGrath to Conor Bowe. Can they produce something here? Can it result in a score? It's over the bar. The vision of Noel McGrath, the scoring of Conor Bowe, magnificent hurling, but it's all down to a wonderful hurler called Noel McGrath.
Yeah, what a contribution Conor Bowe has made. Noel McGrath has eyes in the back of his head, it's just unbelievable.
David Reedy down towards Graham Mulcad, leading it off. Aaron Gillard under pressure, great defending Tipperary. They're doing the essentials, the blocking, the hooking, the courage, the determination, all the ingredients you need for a successful winning team. And that's what Liam Carroll is producing here this afternoon. But can they hold on? Challenge, however, was an illegal one there, as referee Sean Stack rightly spotted it. And it's going to be a free. Let's have a look here. Great block.
Another brilliant block. And that's obviously something Tipperary have worked really, really hard on. Because I can't remember seeing a Tipperary team having as many blocks as they've had today.
Aaron Gillan going for a 7 point. Little bit more of a challenge for the Patrick Swell man here. 10 metres in from the sideline or so. focusing on it. And this goes across the face of the goal. One senses that that was a difficult challenge, difficult angle. Disappointment for John Kiley and Limerick. Heading towards the 67th minute. Nicely picked up by Gerard O'Connor. No free given. Ball is available. Limerick chasing in packs. In comes Darrow Donovan. Scoops it up the second time. Hand passes it back for his captain. Declan Hannan, good ball, good running by Dermot Burns. But again, the pass not great. Oh, one-handed. You can do it when you're a Tipperary man. Well done by Brian O'Mara. Ball comes back out first. Kyle Hayes keeping it along that sideline. David Reedy thought about going long. Back out again for Hayes. Coming in to challenge the Shamie Callan. David Reedy. Build-up is so methodical, but the handling, just a little bit of a disappointment. Good pressure by Tipperary. And Tom Morrissey followed through there. And I think the referee will come back on that. It was a great catch by Barry Nash. Now it's a knockout championship game. It is sparkled for the last 3 or 4 minutes. It was good all the way through. Still, Graham O'Cat on the Tipperary 65-metre line. Has a go, has a lash, and sends it over the bar. Brilliant.
Yeah, the Tip crowd not happy with the challenge over in the far wing. You can see all the players out on their feet now, because this is absolutely has been a savage game from start to finish. Just watch, here's Jake Morris breaking out. And here's Tom Morris flick in. That's a definite free, a yellow card at least. Watch it there.
Yeah, no doubt.
Maybe that a yellow card. Enough, but it should be a free, and that Limerick looking to get away with that one.
Fuck out by Gentle Tats. And somehow it comes in to Conor Sakelam's hands. Barry Nash. Stalemate just outside the Limerick 45-metre line. Throw ball here.
Conor Sakelam here cramping up. And
Tipperary make another change. Johnny Ryan is coming on. Player that's going off is Conor Sakelam. Johnny Ryan played to corner back against Cork for Lower Park McCree. And said, certainly Liam Kyle is throwing everything now, giving fresh players fresh legs. Sean Ryan is in from Temple Derry Kenyans. He played corner forward against Clare and Cork.
Yeah, I think this is great management. He can see clearly that the Tipperary players are flagging out there. It's been a huge game. Limerick's condition, absolutely savage. He's thrown in the fresh legs at the real right time, 4 minutes to go, probably 4 or 5 minutes maybe of injury time.
Can Tipperary hold on? They really have been outstanding. Stalemate again. Gerald O'Connor's in there. Noel McGrath trying to get a touch. Graham Mulcahy playing almost at right corner back. Challenge, and Mulcahy is an illegal one. And that's a free for Limerick. Liam Cahill urging from the sideline.
He's not happy, I'd say. That's up the very soft variety. Some of the things that we've seen today, Graham Mulcahy wasn't looking for it. Nobody was looking for it. He was gone on, and the ref judged it to be a foul. This is a tough one, but this man has usually the mental capacity to score these under serious pressure.
We're past the 70th minute. 6 minutes of an additional time going to be allowed. 6 minutes of drama. Dermot Burns going for his fourth point of the game. It has the legs, it has the accuracy, it has everything. Brilliant, once again, by Dermot Burns. And the sides are level for the seventh time in Semple Stadium. 23 points Tipperary, 23 points Limerick.
Well, that is a brilliant score. He used the wind, he used everything, and just has that absolutely brilliant mental strength to be able to do that under serious pressure.
Michael Breen sends it down the wing. First touch here is vital. Goes off the hands of the substitute that's just been introduced. That's Sean Ryan.
You have to credit the Tip full backline, or the Limerick full backline in the second half. They got roasted in the first half, but they got the grips of Mark Yeo and Jake Morris in the second.
Sideline ball for Limerick. Barry Nash to take it. Doesn't gain an awful lot of ground. Now, who has it here? Tipperary. Dan McCormack. And the referee has given the free to Limerick.
He's going to throw it in, I think, now, because there was a bit of reaction from Barry Nash. He's on a yellow. Is he going to get another one?
Telling everybody to step away. They're all protesting.
Yeah.
Now, Barry Nash is on a yellow card, as Michael just said. There's a second yellow. There's a red.
Yeah, he'd gotten the free and he reacted. He obviously went down. Just watch it here now. So Dan McCormack dropped the head. And rightly so, that was no free. It's after the free is given. Just watch his reaction. He went in and had a word and said something to him, and, you know, unsporting, that's why it was given.
Tom Morrison lays it back. Graham Mulcahy past the Tipperary 45. Yeah. Under pressure, under severe pressure, no foul given. The ball is wide.
Ronan Maher did well there, but Graham Mulcahy should have put that over. There's some tension here in the ground. It's not easy. The rain is coming down there now, fairly heavy as well. Whoever can keep their composure, get one more score, could do it.
And there's still 3 minutes and a bit to go. Position crucial here, but Burns intercepted by Shamie Callanan, the All-Ireland winning captain a few years ago. Puts it between the posts and over the bar. Brilliant Tipperary. The interception, he read it so well. Here comes Shamie Callanan from Drummond Inch, just down the road, and that's what it means to him. Tipperary lead again by just one. Graham Mulcahy causing problems since introduced. He's made the space. Gives it to William O'Donoghue. Mulcahy available again in front of the post. Surely he'll score. Yes, he will. A great response for the Kilmallock back.
Well, there are two brilliant scores, Marty. Seamus Callanan, first of all his experience, you said it, he read it. But Will O'Donoghue, what a second half he's had. Mulcahy missed an easy one a second ago. He didn't miss that. What a game of hurling here in Thurles.
Down comes first Michael Breen. Reece Shelley. Breen floats it up. Tacking the ball is Dermot Barnes. Now that's Limerick. And that's surely a free. No free given.
Mulcahy again.
He's causing problems for Tipperary. Comes back out for his big Tom. Tom Morrison. And that is over the bar. Fantastic play, Limerick. It's four-pointed again. And is it a winner? As we head towards the 75th minute, 25 points, Limerick, 24 points, Tipperary. John McGrath coming out for Tipperary. John Kiley, animated along the sideline. His team have responded to the challenge posed by the Premier County. Absolutely essential now is the possession. Good work here by Ron O'Mara and Brian O'Mara. Sending it down the wing. Sideline ball. Goes to Limerick.
Oh, that's a tip ball. Liam Cahill's gone up here now.
Liam Cahill is really angry.
Aaron Gillan's after giving a dunt off the ball as well there.
Temper sprayed.
To Brian McGrath. But that,
let's have a look at this again.
Off Richie English's knee out over the line, that's a tip ball.
That's why Liam Cahill is animated and angry.
Well, these things turn matches. It should have been. The ref, linesman was right beside James Owens, very experienced official, should get that right.
Ball comes out towards Seamus Kennedy. Laying it on. Seamus Kennedy there. Tipperary man goes down. And it is a free between the 45 and 65. This story has had so many chapters, so many twists and turns, as John McGrath took the knock and stayed down. It's a free for the Premier County. A crucial, crucial moment as we go past the 75th minute and heading towards the 76th. This to level the match for the ninth time.
Now the free taker has gone off, so this is a big one. The last time we saw John McGrath come on, he took one, he missed it. Is John going to take it? Is Noel going to take it? Who's going to take it? And if it is John McGrath, I don't like to see a player who's got an opt taking the free straight after it.
Liam Cahill's got a red card, has he?
Liam Cahill has been and shown a card anyway, that's for sure. I was watching to see who was taking the free.
Red card for Liam Cahill. Jake Morris has come over here now. John McGrath has just come on. He's won this free. He's and been Liam down injured. Noel McGrath's gone off. Gerald O'Connor has gone off.
And Liam Cahill is being banished to the sideline. Now, who's going to take the free?
Well, I think after all this, a draw is the fair result. We'll all go home.
Happy out. And it is, indeed, John McGrath is going to take this. He was the one who was awarded the free.
There's a lot of booing here. We don't like to hear it. Trying to bring it back. Some confusion over the free. It wasn't given initially, then it was given. But here it is, all about John McGrath. This will be the last puck of the game.
We're in the 77th minute. This to level. Limerick in check. He hits it well. And it's gone over the bar. The sides are level again. 9 times in a humdinger of a game in Simple Stadium. The Munster Championship story continues. Every game, every chapter is a little bit different. It took courage by John McGrath, having just been introduced, to step up and score a point to level the game. Liam Cahill and John Kiley can afford to have a bit of crack afterwards and say, no doubt, we probably might meet again. This was an absolute humdinger. 37,459 witnessed a thriller in Simple Stadium. There is a bit of afters going on. The tension is palpable.
Yeah,
and the referee and the linesman will have to deal with this. This is unsavoury and unnecessary. And the officials are doing their best to try and get players separated from each other. Limerick-Tipperary rivalry spilling over here.
Noel McGrath out there with no helmet. He's very unhappy about something. He went back out. He had been taken off. In fairness, I think the players are keeping their discipline. There is a bit of a few players congregated there, not happy about something that happened out in the field, obviously, during the game, Marty. But I don't want to see this. This has been an absolutely classic championship game. We've had everything. I call it a game of swings and roundabouts. Tip looked like they dominated. They should have been further ahead. Limerick powered back into it, but Tip withstood it, went on, played brilliantly. And this keeps it all alive now for next weekend. This is the championship that keeps on giving, this Munster Championship, this round robin. It's absolutely fantastic. We see the football, there's a lot of matches maybe to get to the knockout, but these matches all matter, and that's what we're seeing there. It's just pure passion from the players. It's settled down now, they've gone their separate ways.
Tipperary and Limerick have produced another scintillating encounter. Neighbours playing an intense game of hurling. For Liam Cahill and John Kiley, the championship dreams and hopes are still alive. What a game. So much to talk about. 9 times level. Tipperary, 25 points. Limerick, 25 points. We've a lot to say, a lot to talk about. Joanne.
Yeah, and we'd probably need a year to get all of it in, Marty. Thank you very much to you and to Michael as well. Don't know, not the first time, obviously. We've seen a few bits of scraps happening here in this famous stadium in Thurles. We might get to the argy-bargy a little bit later on. But what this does to the Munster Championship table is, it means it is all going to come down, bar Clare, of course, who are nicely, safely into the final next week, it is going to come down to the final round of fixtures next week. Here you go. Clare already through to the Munster final. We know that after their one-point win over Cork earlier on today. Tipperary, they go to, they play Waterford next week, so many people expect them to beat a Waterford team who struggle in this round-robin system. It'll come down to Limerick against Cork for that final place.
Oh, what a day, Joanne. What a day. What a game. Tipperary threw the kitchen sink at Limerick. And somehow Limerick found a way that it needed Tipperary to get a last-minute equaliser. Outstanding.
They fully deserved it, Joanne, you have to say. And then, like, great champions don't go down handy, do they? And look at the guys they took off, Kylie and his mentors. And the contribution, Graham Mulcahy's contribution.
Yeah.
Incredible contribution.
He was huge in the last few minutes, wasn't he? He won 4 or 5 balls there in the last few minutes, set up. Could have got another score, probably his weak side or whatever. But to make those changes, take off Keane Lynch so early, take off Garrod Hegarty, your half forward line nearly gone. Tom Morrissey stood up. But they'll be happy enough, I think, Limerick, to get a draw at the same time. Unlucky not to win it. but happy enough, I'd say, with the draw.
Tip younger brigade as well, as now we saw Shamey coming in and the McGraths and all, like Brian O'Mara, Bo's contribution off the bench. I mean, Stakelham, the work rate of him all through, incredible mix coming together under Liam Carroll.
And a bit of belief starting to come back into him. Their support has been questionable over the last while, like Tip. It's been questionable how much they've been behind this team, but you could even feel it there in the last couple of minutes, them rising. You have to give Liam Carroll huge credit.
A bit of a row was going on. You could hear tip.
That's exactly it.
And
exactly
even after half time, when Limerick came at them and got the first 4 or 5 points after half time, Tip still hung in there and got back level and went up another 2 or 3 points again. So that's good character in that team, you know.
We're talking about the character, and you were talking about the young players who came on, the difference they made from Tip. And I know Joe in particular thought Brian O'Mara was the key man out there on the pitch. A majority of 2-1 gave it to a different man.
Yeah, we're close, and I think, you know, Joanne, in some ways, if you'd stop the year right now, and we never want that to happen, it's been so great. This guy nearly be hurler of the year at the moment. Noel McGrath has just found a lease of life under Liam Carroll. Now, he's always a great player, Noel, class. But his vision and his work rate and his ability to get into space and play that killer ball where no one else would see is just off the charts. And he was our man of the match.
And this was particularly when it was in the melting pot. I suppose it was in the melting pot the whole time. He controlled things the first half, but in the second half, when Limerick were coming back.
Yeah, well, the first 4 points, John, 4 minutes had gone ahead. And you're saying, you know, here we go again, like, you know. But he was the one that sort of, I think, said, give me the ball, you know, and he's available. Look at the space he finds himself in. Now, maybe John Kiley will be looking back at that and saying, you know, we need to close down a guy like that. But blocking, working, just everywhere around the field, and the vision, like, the one, here it goes, yeah, Conor Boas. Who else had seen Conor Boas gone over there on the right? That's an incredible score.
And you're looking at that from up here, like, and it looks as if there's loads of spaces. Imagine being down there in the middle third with all the bodies going everywhere, referees, the whole lot. It was beautiful to watch him again. He was outstanding down in Páirc Uí Chaoimh, but I would argue that was nearly even a better performance.
He always makes it look like there's loads of space, even when there's not. Noel McGrath, love to know how many of these trophies he has. He's the man of the match, and he's with Damien.
Thanks very much, Joanne. I'm joined by Noel McGrath, who's the Borgash Energy Man of the Match. Teresa Pertil from Borgash Energy is here to present you with your award. Thanks very much, Teresa. Noel, congratulations. I guess these are the days as a hurler that you live for.
Yeah, they are, Damien. Like, I suppose you see here an absolutely packed Semple Stadium. Like, this is what you play for. This is Munster Championship stuff. And I suppose it just went right down to the wire there, and fair play to John there. He stepped up after, I suppose, the one in Cork he was probably disappointed with, to hit it there and get the leveller today. So we go again next weekend and we dust ourselves down.
Just a very quick question. John's mentality there, to be no doubt in his mind whatsoever.
Yeah, look, he's doing it for years, Damien, I suppose, and you miss some, you score some, and that's the character of him and a lot of other players in the team. Like, he had a knock last week against Cork, and he came back and he nailed the last puck today. Like, and that's what you do in sport. There's no point in feeling sorry for yourself. You get up, you go again, and you grind it out, and I'm delighted for him there now.
Noel, it's very hard to make sense of a game like that, but can you give me your view maybe on the shape and structure? You did a lot of hurling, but only led by 3 at half-time. Limerick were well on top after the restart, but Tip clawed their way back into it again. How did you see it faring out?
Yeah, I suppose that the game, look, it went on life of its own. Like, they're a top-class side. Like, we know over the last few years how good they are, like, and what they can do. Like, and we just had to hang in there when they got their patch at the start of the second half. And I think a lot of grit and a lot of fire was shown there by our players today to get ourselves back into that. And it was tit for tat right at the end. And look, we'll take a draw right now. We'll sit down and see, could we have held on a bit better? Could we have got a few more scores when we were 2 or 3 up in the second half? But look, we fought hard at the end to get the leveller, and thankfully we're there to fight another day.
A last question for you, Noel. In your experience now, this probably sounds like a stupid question, but will it be hard to lift yourself for another game next weekend, even though Waterford have nothing to play for? It's a free shot for them, and just the bodies will be so tired after this as well.
As a player, you just want matches, like, and we love this. Like, who doesn't love this? This is a throwback to the mid-2000s when you had packed stadiums with Munster Championship matches with everything on the line, and this is the exact same here now. So I don't think anyone will be complaining. We'll dust ourselves down tonight and tomorrow, and we'll go again.
Thanks, Noel.
Thanks, Damien.